Dr. Huff, it's really good to see you again. We had a very nice visit just a few short weeks ago, and that was all about Joplin receiving the Magna Award, a national award, the grand prize winner for the relationship between the Joplin schools and your community. But CJ, here we are now, and just a few days after a devastating tornado hit Joplin, and now we're seeing a very different kind of collaboration. Could you just share with us a little bit about what is happening here in Joplin relative to resolving these enormous issues that you're dealing with as a superintendent of schools?
Yeah, I mean, it's one of the things that we worked really hard on over the last 3 years is developing that relationship between our community and the Joplin schools, and that goes back further than that. But my experience has been these last 3 years, and we've put some programming in place. Bright Futures Initiative that got the grand prize award at the MSBA conference has been an instrumental program in building that bridge, especially between our business community and our faith-based community. And our human service agencies, and that's paying dividends right now as we struggle with trying to meet the needs of hundreds of families in our district providing for their basic needs. And so we're reaching out to those folks again, and they're stepping up. You know, they're calling us, what can we do for you? What can we do to help out? And everything ranges from people wanting to write a check to bringing in donations, and we had donations arriving that evening, and people calling in, how can we help? It's just nonstop. I mean, we're mobilizing well over 100 volunteers for this weekend to help staff our distribution center to get food and supplies out to our families, it's been quite amazing and quite can't even really put it into words. It's humbling isn't even the right word for that. I mean, I don't know what we'd do without them. And likewise, I think, that relationship works both ways. And some of the things we're doing as a district right now is, how can we provide child care for all these families that have been displaced so they can get their worlds back together. And one of the things we're getting ready to do is plan an extended summer school, something that's going to run from mid-June here on June 13th until the last Friday in July. For any families that need some place to go with their kids. So we're working on some things of that nature. And then obviously our main focus right now is taking care of our kids and finding accounting for the status of our kids and our staff. And right now we have 100% of our staff accounted for and 97% plus of our students at this point. So we're getting closer all the time. As we think about that August 17th target date, working with the contractors obviously is going to be very important. Working with state and local and federal officials to make that happen is very important. Yesterday, we were able to work with the governor's office to get a waiver on the key facilities that we need to have available for us on August 17th, and that one of those being Cecil Floyd Elementary, which houses well over 600 elementary students. Many of our special needs programs are in that building. Our administrative offices, where we hold we house all our servers, all our student information systems. I mean, they're up and going. We've got a makeshift roof on it currently, but I need to get all my administrative team back together. We're kind of scattered across the district right now, dealing with a lot of different things. We need to have a central headquarters, and that's really important for us. Which, by the way, our building got hit by the tornado at 5:30 on Sunday night. We made payroll the next day, believe it or not. Mm-hmm. So our business operation services, I mean, we became fully functional almost immediately through generators and great tech support. And then lastly, and probably the biggest challenge we have is East Middle School. It's a brand new middle school. We passed a bond issue 3 years ago to build 3 new middle schools. It took a direct hit. We lost everything pretty much south of the office area, gymnasium, auditorium, cafeteria area, and significant damage to the roof across the building. And so just got out of a meeting with the contractors following the governor's waiver that we were able to get yesterday. We were able to select contractors yesterday afternoon with our school board approval, and we're able to rehire basically the contractors that built it 18 months ago, as well as the architect. So they know it inside and out. They're just going back to put it like it was, and they already understand the challenges. So I think we've got a real shot at hitting that target. I don't know that we'll have the gymnasium and auditorium and cafeteria ready to go, but that's where FEMA comes into play. There's the potential to build some temporary gymnasium space that could be multifunctional So we've got about I'll know more in about a week where we're at with contractors in terms of lead time on materials, and then we make some decisions on working with FEMA to put up a temporary structure. So I'm pretty confident, and they're telling me, you know, we're working with Crossland Construction here locally, and they've got a huge firm, and then R.E. Smith locally as well at Cecil Floyd and our admin building, and they feel very confident that they can hit that target date. And if that's the case, that takes care of the 4,200 students. We've displaced about 62% of our student population as a result of this tornado. You know, we have other buildings that are damaged too, but if we can take care of those two buildings, that certainly gives us some options that we can start looking at, and helps narrow the focus a little bit in terms of how we're going to have school this next fall. But we're going to have obviously an option A, B, C, and D on this thing, and we've got a great team put together to take care of that. And then obviously another challenge, enrollment projections. We had, I may have mentioned, 3,420 kids who were in that path of destruction, and the homes that are lost. You know, where are they going to go? Is it going to be a Hurricane Katrina effect where everybody leaves? Or are they going to stay? Which I think was an important message that we sent out early, that we're going to have school. That's sometimes a determining factor on whether or not people are going to stay, and we want our families to stay in Joplin and go through this rebuilding process. So there's a lot of moving parts to this thing, and we just kind of learn as we go, just giving our leaders in our district a high degree of autonomy to make some good decisions.
CJ, obviously there's been a real outpouring of concern and interest, and people are asking themselves the question, how can we help? And clearly what Joplin needs today may be a little bit different than what you need 3 weeks or 6 months from now. But what is it that not only individuals but school districts and the school community can do to reach out and support you in this crisis?
Short-term food's an issue for folks, and we're pushing a lot of food out through our distribution system. But also short-term and long-term cash donations are great. You know, we need to be able to specifically target individual family needs, and we've established a Joplin Schools Tornado Relief Fund, and through U.S. Bank, who we do banking with, and people can make a donation to that anywhere in the nation, and they can walk into any U.S. bank in the nation and make donations. But those cash donations are really important for us as we rebuild and take care of some of our short-term needs as those turn up, which there's a number of those. I mean, we're trying to figure out, okay, how do we have summer camps? How do we do weight training for kids who are getting ready for football this fall? You know, band uniforms and instruments, and you know, you name it. We've got a lot of challenges ahead of us there. But again, you know, we're letting people tell us what they need, and we're going to try to meet those needs. But a lot of that's going to require cash to make that happen.
CJ, you've had you've mentioned that many school districts have reached out to you already. What kind of support has been most meaningful, and what is it that we can do as a school community to do more to assist you in your resolving of these issues?
Thoughts and prayers are greatly appreciated, and I can't say enough. And I feel bad because I haven't been able to respond to hardly any of the words of encouragement that I've got via text message or email. And you know, I wanted to say thank you to those folks as well as apologize for not getting back to them. It's been a little crazy around here, you know, as far as what they can do for supporting us, and the kinds of support we've gotten, I mean, I can't even begin to tell you, because there's so many things happening out there that I'm not even aware of. You know, we've been cut off pretty much from the outside world. We don't have, you know, cable, no TV. We just got a satellite hookup today so we can start following the national news and what's going on out there. And I've not had time to get on Google and see what's happening. You know, I wake up every morning, come to work, we deal with the stuff, I go home, try to get some sleep. Right now, school districts, you know, thoughts and prayers. I know there are a lot of fundraisers going on out there, and any financial support they can give to us is great. And if they have people with areas of expertise they think might be able to help us out, or previous experience, would be great as well. We're going to reach out sometime the next couple of days to Superintendent Greensburg over in Kansas, where that tornado went through and destroyed the entire community a few years back. Try to learn from them, but we're in learning mode. There isn't anything, I've not seen a textbook written on this thing anywhere, and we're just trying to figure things out as we go. But
CJ, when you were preparing to be a superintendent of schools through your professional education and work experience in public education, Did you ever imagine in your wildest dreams that you'd have to deal someday with a situation like this?
No, it's pretty surreal. Sunday night, after the devastation, after the tornado blew through, my wife and I tried to get out of our subdivision to see what had happened. We didn't even know that a tornado had gone through at that point. And the power was off and we knew something had happened, and got on the road and tried to get out of our subdivision and couldn't because of the damage. And then went the other way, and really the first significant damage we saw was St. John's Hospital and that entire area. And I've got one elementary school that was close by there. Irving Elementary School was completely destroyed, and that entire school community leveled. And when you're superintendent of schools, you feel a great degree of responsibility for all your kids. And then we went down Connecticut towards my office so that I could get my laptop. I knew we had to set up an emergency operations center of some kind and start following our emergency plan. And I'd left my laptop at my office because we had a graduation that day, and I'd been in there on Sunday morning early to finish up my graduation speech. And we left graduation at 5:20, and the tornado sirens were going off. And I grew up in Kansas. I'm used to tornadoes, but I've never seen anything like this. And as I heard more, and I knew that when I learned that JHS had been completely destroyed and FTC had been completely destroyed, and that those neighborhoods and the families impacted, and there was that sense of, what in the world, where to even start. So on Monday, it was just trying to get our heads wrapped around the scope of the work, on no sleep that needed to be done. And then, putting together a plan of action, we tried to keep it simple. And on Tuesday morning, I woke up and said, we got to have school. And brought my leadership team together, and I said, school starts in 84 days. Let's do it. And they kind of looked at me, was like, all right, let's get it done. So we're hard at it, and we're going to get there. We're going to get there.
CJ, I know there's lots of things that we haven't even touched upon. Is there anything specifically that you would like to share with our viewers today that you would want them to know?
Well, just keep us in our thoughts and prayers. We got a lot of work to do, a lot of things to think about. I think the main thing is just keep praying for our kids. We're still locating all our students, and certainly keep praying for us. And if there's anything we need, we appreciate Missouri School Board Association's support, and we'll reach out to you guys and let you know what we need as that time arises. But can't say enough for the support you've given us already, so thank you.